Good morning, guys. So I really wanted to start this vlog earlier while we were still at the house, but as usual, we were running around getting ready and trying to get out of the house in time, so we're starting in the car. But anyways, so last night we kind of left you guys with a cliffhanger. So would you like to tell them where we are on our way to?
You don't want to tell them?
I don't know. We are on our way to the courthouse to get married. So, all right. So basically, with that said, today is not our wedding day. Basically, what we've been playing with this idea ever since a certain someone got elected, would you say?
Yes.
Yeah. So, I mean, you guys have kind of been following along with our journey and the whole, you know, uncertainty of being gay in today's political climate. And so we made the decision a while ago and that we would get legally married earlier than our actual wedding, just to kind of safeguard our legal status. So hopefully, should anything unfortunate happen, we can hopefully get grandfathered in and we are legally married and we have that security. So yeah, we went back and forth for a while on whether or not we wanted to do it, because, you know, we don't want to be doing this. Yeah, this is not how we wanted to get married. We wanted to, you know, get married at our wedding. But it was, I mean, the safety aspect of it, legal wise, was important enough to us that we decided to just kind of do it to have it be legal and then go ahead with our normal wedding as planned.
Yes.
So we're still having our wedding. That is still very much our wedding day and our wedding date. We have already talked about it, and we are not even going to call ourselves married after today. We are still fiancés. We're still engaged. We're still planning our wedding.
We're signing a piece of paper.
We are signing a piece of paper today. Exactly. That's all today is. But since it is part of our story, I did kind of want to include it in the vlogs and kind of let you guys know what is going on and explain it a little bit to you guys. And yeah, so I mean, do you have anything else to add? Did I miss anything?
No. I mean, it's not... I mean, we didn't tell our whole family. Like, we told our parents.
Yeah, we told our parents. They know that we're going today.
We didn't tell, like, everybody in the family. We didn't, you know...
Mostly because we didn't want it to be viewed as our wedding in any way. We didn't want it taking away from our wedding.
Yeah.
So, you know, we decided to kind of keep it really small, and today where it's just going to be us and the judge there. We didn't, you know, we didn't want anyone there again so that it wouldn't be seen as our wedding day at all. It's just technicalities and making it official and legal. And yeah.
Also, I'm applying to schools, so this is going to help a lot with financial aid.
There's that.
Seriously, that is a good, yeah. That seriously made an impact on the decision.
Yeah.
Because I get to put it down on my financial aid form that I'm married.
Yeah.
So that helps with getting more money.
There's that.
We're trying to make it a not serious thing. And so by making that.
And also kind of as many silver linings as we can find, because like I said before, we don't want to be doing this.
Yeah, it's not like we want to do the, like,
Yeah. So yeah, but we did kind of get a little dressed up. I'll show you guys what we're wearing later, since we're obviously in the car. I can't really show you, but we got dressed up just because, you know, I don't know. I like getting dressed up, but also because, yeah, like I said, we're trying to make this semi-fun for ourselves, I guess, if we have to do it.
Yeah.
So yeah, oh, one more thing. So, all right, again, going along with the whole, we don't want this seen as our wedding or anything like that, we are not going to include anything in the courthouse in the vlog. Just, I mean, I don't know. I don't, yeah. Again, I don't want it to be our wedding, and so it's not special. And yeah. So I won't be filming that, but I wanted to let you guys know what we were doing and keep you in the loop. So yeah, we are driving there now, and I will check in with you guys after. All right, guys. It's done.
We married.
Mm-hmm. It was nice and easy.
It literally took like 2 minutes.
Yeah. And like there was no line, so it was nice. We like got there, we kind of signed in or whatnot, I guess. And then we waited on a bench for like 30 seconds, yeah. And then the judge came out and got us, and we walked into a little ceremony room. We were both so awkward. We're like, so where do we stand? What do we get?
It was very awkward.
Yeah. But it wasn't, like, awkward. I think it was, I don't know.
It was good.
Yeah.
It was fine.
Yeah. I don't know. We exchanged our rings, because since we both had engagement rings, we kind of just decided to do that. We don't have, obviously, our wedding bands yet, but that's because we didn't get married yet. But, yeah, it was, for what it is, it was a nice thing.
Yeah.
You know?
It was good.
Yeah. I don't know what else to say about it.
Now we're going to get coffee.
Yeah, now we're going to get coffee, and we're trying to figure out what we want to do tonight, because we, like, want to do something, like, maybe go out to dinner, or at least, like, get dinner to take home, and I know I want cocktails of some sort. That was my one request for, celebration, I guess.
Yeah.
So, we're trying to decide, because I think we might just buy stuff to make it at home, because honestly, you spend freaking, like, you know, $10 to get one drink out. Like,
it's
just such a waste of money. It's so expensive. So, yeah, I think we might just make our own at home and do that. Mm-hmm. And then we can use some of our fancy new Waterford stuff.
Yes.
Which I'm excited about. And, yeah. So, yeah. That's done.
I wasn't going to take off work tomorrow, but I think I might, just because it's like, all right, well, we're home. Like, we might as well enjoy our evening and not have to, like, all right, I gotta go to bed early to go to work tomorrow.
Yeah. And so, even when you took off the first day, your boss was like, boss, you're not like, taking off Friday?
Yeah. I was like, no. She's like, okay. So, like, everybody made me feel weird and awkward for not taking off tomorrow. So, I think I'm just gonna text her and be like, so, yeah.
Yep.
We're gonna do that.
And let's go get some coffee. Are you going to judge me if I get an iced latte?
Yes, it's 45 degrees out.
Oh, that's not that cold. That's not even close to how cold it can get in Baltimore.
It's gotten below zero in Baltimore before.
All right.
Coffee.
We haven't gotten coffee out in a long time. All right, so we just went into one of our favorite places to get, like, coffee and snacks and stuff, and I got an iced caramel latte. Oh, Atwater's. I was, like, leading up to it, and I never said the name. We went to Atwater's, and, yeah, so I got an iced caramel latte, and Melissa got a pour-over coffee. I got a grilled ham and cheese sandwich, and we got a cute little celebratory macaroon in the shape of a heart.
To be right around Valentine's Day, so everything's all hearts.
All romantic.
Stuff.
Is that like glittery? It looks like glittery.
Yes, it's gold.
I'm not sure. Can you guys see that? I think you can see it. Yeah. So we thought we would split a glittery heart macaroon between the two of us.
That was hard. I got it.
You're good.
You have gold lips now.
Do I?
Mm-hmm.
Keys.
Seriously, look in the mirror.
I do. Alright, so what are we doing?
We're going to buy you liquor.
We're heading up.
Gotta get our liquored up, guys.
So we made a semi-plan for the evening. Hold on. We are going to get sushi for dinner, but we're going to bring it home and eat it at home, but we're not going to eat dinner on the couch. We're going to eat dinner at the dining table. Like real grown-ups. So, yeah. But if you've been following along for a while, I know we mentioned it on our anniversary, but sushi has kind of always been like our relationship food of choice, I guess. Like, we used to get it a lot when we first started dating, and so it's just kind of, I don't know, special, I guess, to us. So, yeah. So we decided that we're going to get some sushi and bring it home and eat it there, and then I think we're going to watch a movie and make cocktails at home. And that's the plan. So we're going to head up to Wegmans and hopefully get some liquor.
Mara's got to decide what she wants, though.
I do have to decide what I want.
Our wedding day has turned into running around to stores. Casual, normal day.
But, like, would you have it any other way?
No, I wouldn't.
So yeah, status update. We stopped at Wegmans. We got some fancy gin. We figured we'd kind of splurge a little on ourselves. So we got Bombay. Right? Yeah, Bombay Sapphire Gin. Not the, because there was like two options. There was Sapphire Gin and there was like extra dry or something like that. We got the blue bottle. That's pretty. And then you went in to Wegmans. Got stuff for mixer.
I got some tonic water because we're going to have the bottle of gin now.
Yeah.
And I got a grapefruit and then two blood oranges because Merritt looked up a thing for like grapefruit martinis, which is basically grapefruit juice and gin.
Yeah.
Sugar. So I'm gonna make simple syrup, which is just water and sugar. You gotta just boil it for a little bit together.
But you also got blood orange stuff for you.
Yes.
Too. So we have two options for cocktails, and now we are on a mission to find martini glasses.
Yes,
because we figured if we're gonna be Did you see that car, like how it was lifted? It was like literally, it was like the opposite of riding dirty.
No,
like
not.
Butt was like way up in the air and the front was, anyways. We are trying to find martini glasses now. Melissa looked while she was in Wegmans and didn't see any she liked. We went to Target and they only had metal ones. So.
That's a thing.
I know it's a thing, but that's not what we want. We want traditional glass, or you know what I mean?
Are there any stores in this shopping center up here?
With Qdoba?
Yeah.
Not that I can think of off the top of my head. I don't think it's really like a store type of place.
Yeah.
We were thinking maybe we're going to try Home Goods if we make it all the way down. I don't know. We're driving.
Stop, stop.
Oh. Fire department. Off the hook. We're waiting. I renewed my registration and we're waiting for it to get in the mail. So right now we have that like temporary registration that you print out and you're supposed to put it in the back.
But
like in the window.
In the window.
I gave it to Melissa. Yeah, she didn't put it in the window.
It's in the car.
Your fault. But yeah, so we are on the search for martini glasses. Wish us luck. Alrighty guys, final update. We are successful.
It's literally 3 hours later. We spent 3 hours
looking for freaking martini glasses.
And like four or five different stores.
Let's see, we started at Wegmans.
Okay, no, here's the kicker.
Yeah.
Wegmans had martini glasses.
They just weren't good enough.
And I didn't buy them. I was like, let's go just stop at Target. Target didn't have them.
Kohl's didn't have them. Stebbins Anderson, which is a store that had glasses, didn't
have them. It's one of those stores that, like, sells everything.
Yeah. They didn't have them. The other kitchen store we were going to look at in that little Kenilworth mall is apparently closed. So they didn't have them. And then we finally decided to suck it up and just go to Home Goods, which I suggested first. Home Goods had it. But not really.
It's dark now.
Yeah. It's 7 o'clock. But like, and we didn't even get traditional. They're not stemmed martini glasses. They're basically stemless with like a little ball, which I thought was nice and kind of like, I don't know. I'm kind of excited about them. I really like them. But still, after all that, like we didn't even get classic. We still had to kind of compromise is what I'm getting at. Like apparently martini glasses just don't exist in the world anymore. It's a lost art.
I don't get it, but
yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah. So, anyways, we are finally...
It got
finally...
to the point where, like, it was now we were taking it personally.
Yeah, we're like, we're finding these freaking glasses.
We weren't going home without them. So now we're going to pick up sushi.
And then we're heading home.
Yeah.
All right, so we are back home, and I wanted to really quick show you guys what we were wearing for the day. Just, I don't know, I think it's fun to show, like, fun outfits for events to show what we were wearing. So anyways, Melissa, would you like to go first? To start off with, she is wearing a pair of her grandmother's earrings. And that's what they look like. They're what, black diamonds and diamonds? If you can see that, they're kind of tiny. I'm trying to get as close as I can without unfocusing. But, and then she's wearing this pink and blue and white striped button down, some gray slacks, and some dress shoes. Hi, Dakota, what are you wearing? All right, can you do the camera?
That's
you
good. See?
Yeah, okay. All right, so this is what I was initially wearing. I'm wearing this jacket, which you guys have kind of already seen. And then I'm wearing the black dress that I bought over the winter from Francesca's. It looks like this, just a pretty, you know, basic black dress. And then I'm wearing these shoes, which are from White House Black Market and are officially killing my feet.
Hi, Dakota.
They are not the easiest to keep on, and I definitely have some blisters. All right, and then I am wearing these like pearl and diamond cluster dangly earrings. And I'm also wearing a necklace that belonged to my grandmother.
Do you see it?
Kind of. Well, it's this kind of like halo style diamondy simple necklace that, I don't know. And then I'm wearing just kind of a diamond and whatever tennis bracelet. And that's all I have on, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So yeah, that's what we wore. And now we are going to change into comfy clothes. Right, Dakota? Yep. We're going to change into the comfy clothes. Come here.
And to start off our marriage the right way, I took off work tomorrow.
You're not even a little aiming at us.
I'm going to clean.
You're going to clean? The apartment?
Yes.
Nice.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to snuggle my mom's. Alrighty, so my awesome fiance has whipped us up some cocktails. And I don't know why, but to me, cocktails just, that's like the celebratory drink. I feel like wine is just a normal, you know, drink with dinner. But cocktails is like a fun, special occasion. That's what I look forward to. Like, I don't know. So we did a gin, I did a gin grapefruit martini. Melissa did a gin blood orange martini thing. And she made our own simple syrup, is that what it's called?
Mm-hmm.
Basically like boiled sugar and water to put in it. And so here is my drink, and these are the cute little glasses that we got from Home Goods. How adorable are they? They're technically cosmopolitan glasses, but I feel like they're totally stemless martini glasses as well. I'm really excited about them. And I think they will get a lot of use. I'm really excited about them. And they were only like $7 for four of them,
yes.
Which is freaking awesome. Home Goods, the best. And if you want the recipe for at least my cocktail, I tweeted the like blog post where it has, you know, all the amounts of ingredients and like the instructions and stuff like that. So yeah, if you're interested in that, check out the link on Twitter. It's at Label McMerritt. And yeah, and for Melissa's, she just substituted grapefruit juice for blood orange juice. So it's basically the same thing. Alrighty, and so here is Melissa's, and hers is obviously a little redder from the blood orange. And so yeah, those are our cocktails for the evening. I'm really excited to try it. Thanks, Annie.
You're welcome.
Hey, go look at the sky right now. Venus is like the closest to Earth in many years. It's huge, like not some star bullshit. This is worth going outside for.
All right, guys, pardon the yellowness.
We're outside.
We're outside and there's a bunch of street lamps, but our best friend, Merritt's best friend, just texted her and said to go outside and look at Venus.
Because it's like the closest to Earth that it's been in like years, and it's huge.
That is Venus. There's the moon.
And it's supposedly trees. Mars is like the little red thing up and to the right of Venus. But I don't think we can see
it. I don't see Mars, yeah. We're gonna walk up the hill a little more and go look.
Cheers. Yours is more than mine.
Yeah? Cheers, darling.
Maybe more like ice melted than yours.
Mmm. That's really good.
Dakota got a bone. We've just been hanging out, watching TV.
Drinking our cocktails.
Merritt's on number two.
I'm on number two. I'm like halfway through number two, so it's been sitting there.
Yeah, I can't drink that much. I fall asleep.
I know. I'm like literally fighting to keep my eyes open right now.
We're starting.
They're so lame.
Narcos. I've really been wanting to watch it.
And we ran out of all of our other shows.
And we have nothing to watch.
We watched The 100, though. Episode 1 of whatever season it is now.
That's a good show. I like that show. Now Dakota found on.
I got her a little present for today, too. Because she's a legitimate puppy now. So you guys can hang out and watch the dog while we watch our show. I'm going to put you up here. You done?
Was that so tasty? Yes, thank you, Mom. That was so nice of you to get me a bone.
She didn't eat the whole thing. She chewed on it. Actually, it's one of those ones where she's not going to eat it all. Yeah.
Go get a drink of waters. Go get some water.
Alrighty. We're going to start heading to bed.
Narcos is the best show ever.
So good. She's been like dying to start watching it for the last couple months. And I keep being like, no, we have other shows we're trying to catch up on. Yeah. But we are finally all caught up on our shows that we're like able to watch. And so we started watching Narcos tonight.
Yep.
It's good.
It's good.
It's really good.
Someone's annoyed.
Someone's ready for bed.
Yeah.
You sleepies. Yeah. So yeah, we're going to head to bed. And, I don't know. We had a kind of exciting, not important day. What?
How does your dad put it?
He said, wishing you an understated congratulations or something. What did he say? Hold on. Let me get it.
I can't wait to make another drink tomorrow.
Oh my god, I know. Those were delicious. Like I was saying to Melissa, like more than worth it to make it at home. Like I would have easily paid $15 for a cocktail like that and been totally satisfied. Like it was really good.
Well, so like we bought a whole bottle of gin and the whole bottle was like $20.
And we basically drank the neck of it.
I said, I just said to Merritt, I was like, we would have went out for dinner and I would have gotten a glass of wine and you would have gotten a drink and we would have paid $20 just for those two drinks.
Yeah.
Like, it's totally worth it to just buy, like, you know,
and it was still just as tasty.
Yeah, it was good. They were awesome.
But anyways, my dad said a very understated congratulations to you and Melissa. Because we, like, told my parents that we didn't want to make a, you know, like, we told you guys that we didn't want to make it into a big deal or, like, this it was not our wedding. We just, yeah, but I thought that was a good way to put it. But, yeah, so, yeah, it was a very understated, exciting day. I love you.
I love you.
We love you.
Yes, we love you.
You're a legitimate pom now.
You're a legitimate puppy. No longer living in sin.
She's like, I don't want to go to bed, guys.
No. All right. Oh, sorry. Well, I hope you enjoyed following along with our...
Sorry if it was a little boring. We just kind of like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I had a good day.
No, I had a good day, too.
Running around getting our martini glasses. I'm really excited with the glasses we ended up with. I think those will get a lot of good use.
Yes.
I think they're really cute.
We'll use them tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow, guys, we're going to organize our china cabinet.
Yes.
That's back
in Melissa's office. The old.
There. Yeah. Right behind me.
It used to be the dining room.
Our sofa table behind us,
that
and the bar cart.
Some of our crystal, and then
the bar cart over there.
So we have like a whole bunch of new like glassware stuff that's been just sitting on the floor next to the sofa table that needs to like be put away, but like we can't put it away because like the china cabinet and everything is just not organized.
Also, we haven't gone through the china cabinet and cleared it out or organized it since we moved in.
Yeah,
and. We haven't done that with the sofa table either.
I've kind of done the sofa table. It really
not like a real purge though.
Okay.
No?
Yeah, I have.
Oh, okay. Well, I feel like tomorrow. Merritt's got two vlogs to edit.
I haven't really like cleared it out and organized it like fully. I don't know. Yeah.
Well, tomorrow that's what we're doing.
Yeah. We're getting all of our glassware in order.
Yeah. And then I took off tomorrow, so I'm off for the weekend now. Mm-hmm.
And you guys should have two vlogs today when you're watching this because
Merritt didn't get
to I edited almost all of yesterday's vlog, but like we had to leave to go to the courthouse because like there was a limited time that they do it each day, and so we had to leave and then we were, you know, doing other stuff, but
she's like falling asleep watching you talk.
Yeah.
We should go to bed though.
I know, I'm really tired.
Tomorrow and
Alright, well I hope you guys enjoyed watching the
Yeah, hold on.
What are you doing?
I'm cleaning it. Okay. Am I weird?
Yes. All right. Give this... Stop it. All right, give this video...
I love you.
I love you too.
Stuck with me.
I know, we want to go to bed.
She's already regretting it.
Alright, for the fifth time, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and we will see you guys tomorrow.
Good night.
Good night.